Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Stephanie. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create a full AI application without having to write a single line of code. I find that this is especially useful for people who are founders or professionals or even students who have like a project to work on, or you're looking to build your own MVP and you are not technical, you don't know how to write code. This is definitely a good place to start. So stick with me to the end of this tutorial as I'm going to show you step by step how to achieve your goal of building a full-blown application without writing a single line of code. Let's get started. So for the tool, I'm using Google AI Studio. Google AI Studio has a general free version. You can use Google AI Studio to generate media, that is images, videos. I've already done a tutorial on that already. I'm going to link it somewhere in this video so that you can go check it out. And in Google AI Studio, you can also build a full application without having to write a single line of code. For this tutorial, I'm going to be building an application that helps me with content creation as a content creator, right? As a content creator, content creation is one of the main things I do. So today's tutorial is going to focus on a content creation application for content creators or for founders or for students even. And so I'm going to be using this exact prompt. First of all, I want to generate the features I'll need for this application. And then from there, I'll be able to sort of like use a prompt to build entire app. So I'm going to come into the chat functionality in here. This is the exact prompt I'm going to use. Give me some MVP features for my content creation application. And then I'm going to click on run. So let's see what we get as an output. Okay, so this has been generated for us. Let's see some of the recommended features we need to have in our application. So you can see we need, the first feature we need to have is something around user authentication. And so we need to have a sign up page and we need to have a login page. And then in terms of like the main application, the interface, we need to have like a content creation interface. So what this means is that you want to have like a button or a way to start creating a new piece of content. And then we need to have like a basic editor. So it could be like a text-based editor, an image-based editor, or a video-based editor. It really depends on what we want to go in for. And then in terms of when it comes to like content management, we are looking to have like a dashboard, which is a place where we can see all our created or our drafted content. And then we need to have the ability to edit that content and also have the ability to delete that content as well. And then in terms of the output, which is like very crucial for MVP, we need to have the ability to export the contents that we create in the application or have the ability to like publish it, let's say to LinkedIn, to YouTube, or to another social media platform. Okay, so this is really good. It also gives you some key considerations to consider when choosing an MVP, and it's saying that you need to focus on one core problem you're trying to solve, and then you also need to think of how you can simplify the entire solution, and you need to have like a feedback loop and also understand how viable the solution is going to be. So this is good. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy this exact MVP features we have in here that was given to us from the Google AI Studio chat section, and I'm going to copy this and I'm going to click on a build section. Now in the build section, I'm going to click on start from a template, and I'm going to click on prompt. And so in the prompt, all I'm going to say is build a content creation application with these features, and then I'm going to paste the features I copied from the previous step in here. Now let's see what we get. So it's going to write the entire code we need and it's going to build everything for us. So we'll see what we get as an output. The good thing about this is as it's building, you can see that it's showing you like a preview of how it would look like, which is really cool. This model is also very smart because it's able to see that there are some errors with the files and it's able to sort of tell you that it's analyzing the errors that have been found in the application. Okay, so this is complete now. Let's see what we got. So I'm going to start with like the various files we have. So now we have multiple files. So eventually, if we decide that we like the design and we want to hand this over to a developer, then we can also hand over the files to them so that they have an idea of what the design is. So this is definitely, I'll say, like a good prototype. Now coming back to the functionality itself, I'm going to come in here and in the preview, let's see if we have an authentication screen. Let me make it full screen. Okay, so there's a new document here and you can really put in the documentation title. So let's say if I say test and I click on test document and I can put in this is a test. Okay, so I do see that there's the ability to save the document and there's about ability to delete the document. So if I click on save, this document is saved for us. And let's say if I want to, I don't see an authentication screen, which is one of the requirements I needed. So I'm just gonna say add a login screen or add an authentication screen. So I'm gonna do that as another add-on onto the code and let's see what I get. This is really good. I like the fact that, as you can see, we have like the email and the password ready. I can see that the files are still generating, but this is good. Like, I like the view. This is exactly what I was asking for. So once this is done, maybe the next thing I'll want to do is probably to change the colors just to see how that would also work. And I'll test this entire application out to see if this is a fully fledged application we could use. Okay, so this is complete. So that's really good. The next thing is I just want to change the color. So I'll say change the color to red. Okay, I'm just going to change it to red and see how that works as well. Okay, so this is really good. The color has been changed to red for us. So this really satisfies my curiosity around, okay, if I want to make changes, how easy is it and all that. So that is really good. So I'm going to try it out right now. So I'm first going to sign up and see if I can log in and see how this would work. I'm going to make this full screen. So I'm going to enter my email. Then I'm going to enter a password. I'm going to click on sign up. Okay, so it's telling me that sign up was successful and it automatically logs me in. Now, if I come in here and I want to create a new documentation, I'm going to say test document. And then if I click on save documents, as you can see, the document has been saved. If I come in here and I say this is a test, and then I click on save again, it should save it for us. If I come back in here and I click on new document, I'll say test 2. I'll be able to write in the documentation and everything. So this is really good. I see how this can be very useful. If I should continue prompting this application, I'll be able to probably build some more functionality into it. So this is definitely useful. So now that I have demoed how to build an application without writing a single line of code or without having any technical know-how, here are my genuine thoughts about vibe coding or building an application without any technical know-how. Let's talk about it. So building apps without code, is it all hype or is it actually useful? Honestly, I would say it's both powerful and practical. Here's what I've learned from using no-code tools and AI tools to build applications without having to touch a single line of code. Let's start with the pros. So anyone can build. You don't need to be a developer or even tech savvy. If you can describe what you want to build, then you can definitely start building it. As you saw, it's also very fast. So you can go from idea to working up in hours and not weeks. Thirdly, there's no big budgets needed. Many no-code tools are free, like the one I just used, or they are super affordable. So they are great for startups, side hustles, or even creators. And you can focus on creativity. So you're not stuck in debugging errors. You can focus on ideating and creativity. And this is where vibe coding shines. You don't need to write a single line of code, and you get the ability to shape the app with your own intent, and then AI sort of fills in the blanks. But there are certain cons that you need to keep in mind as well. You are sort of limited in terms of the tools and the features that are available to you. So if you need, let's say, complex logic, heavy customization, or you need advanced backend stuff, it might not cut it. Also, scaling can be a bit tricky because no code is just great for MVPs, in my opinion, and testing ideas. But then at scale, traditional devs may be more stable. Also, you depend on the platform. So if this platform shuts down, changes prices, or removes a feature, then you are stuck. So when should you use vibe coding, or when should you vibe code? If you have a cool idea and you want to prototype it fast, this is definitely a good idea. You're building something simple like a landing page, a quiz app, an AI chatbot, or a content tool, and you want to test the waters before investing in developers, this is definitely a place to start. It's a good way to go. So the bottom line in all of this is that vibe coding is perfect for creators, entrepreneurs, and non-techies who want to move fast and also make something real without waiting on a dev team. So it's not for everything, but it's definitely the future of how you're going to be building an application and the role AI is going to play in software development. Yeah, that is it for today's tutorial. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I've done other tutorials on this channel that you can go check out. I'm going to leave them on the screen so that you can check it out. If you haven't subscribed as well, I encourage you to subscribe to my channel. See you in the next one.